So, if you've decided to buy a new Galaxy Note 9 and put a $1,000 bill in your pocket, you're gonna wanna get your money's worth. And that means one thing, mastering the S Pen. The S Pen has gotten a major upgrade on the Galaxy Note 9. For one, it now comes in two colors, lavender purple that matches the phone of the same color, and bright yellow to complement the deep ocean blue model. But the new look isn't the only thing that's different. The S Pen is also finally powered by Bluetooth for the first time, giving the stylus some new capabilities. So let's take a look at some of the new features and some of the cool things it can do. So when the phone is unlocked, when you eject the S Pen, you'll get the Air Command menu automatically if you select that, and you'll have six options that are all customizable. You click the little edit button here, and you can go into your settings and customize all that stuff. We'll get into that a little bit later. First thing I want to show you is the remote part of the S Pen, which is the new part, and it's by far the coolest thing about it. So when you go into the settings, you'll see a new option at the top called S Pen Remote. Tap that, and you'll get a whole bunch of new options. First thing you see on the top is an on-off switch. Turn it off, and it just works just like the S Pen from the Note 8. You can use it to draw and tap, and the phone recognizes it, but you lose the remote capabilities of the Bluetooth. So if you do turn the Bluetooth functionality off on your phone and you want to turn it back on, you're going to need to put the phone back into the holster. It'll still say disconnected, and it'll give you a little warning that it needs to repair with the phone. So you plug it back in. It takes about maybe 3 seconds. It says connecting, and it says available. Take it out, and you're ready to go. Another thing you'll see right below that is the battery percentage. In this case, it says 100%, and it usually will say 100% when you take it out, since it takes about 40 seconds for it to charge fully. However, it drains very fast. If you're using it as a remote to play music, to do presentations and slides and things, you can actually see the battery drain. I tested it in, you know, a pretty extreme situation, and I got to about 420 clicks until it died. So, you know, that's probably more than you're gonna need, but it does have, you know, it's about a half hour, depending on how you're clicking and depending on how you're using it for when the pen will die. But you just plug it back in, 40 seconds later, you take it out, and it's, you know, it's fully charged. So it shouldn't be too much of an issue for many people. So below that, you'll see app actions. And those are the things that you can control with your button on the S Pen. You'll see camera, you'll see gallery, you'll see shutter and media, things like this. There's only a few for now. Samsung has an SDK, and developers will get involved in this, and they'll start integrating into their apps. And you know, there's actually a bunch of Samsung ones that aren't even available. So I'd say within 6 months to a year, it'll be much more robust, but right now it's pretty limited. The default option, and the one people are gonna use the most, is the camera. So you can customize the button in three different ways. So when you tap on the setting, it says hold down pen 2. Tap on that and you will get a list of all of the apps on your phone as well as a couple of S Pen features. And they can launch when you press and hold the button for about a second or two. And you can also use the button for single clicking and double clicking, which do separate actions. So we'll use the camera for an example. So you can set a long press of the button to launch the camera, and you can set a single press of the button to either take a picture, switch between the front and the back camera, or record video, and the same thing with the double press. So you're actually adding two separate actions to the pen. So it works with Bluetooth, so you could be up to 30 feet away, you click that button and you'll snap a picture. So if your phone's on a tripod and you're trying to get a bunch of people, or you're doing one of these funky selfies, you don't have to worry about, you know, reaching over to click the screen. You can just click your pen. So, you know, it will come in handy in some instances. So there's no speaker in the S Pen. So if you leave it behind, it's not going to make a noise or it's not going to let you know. But you can turn on an alarm on your Note 9 and it will make a sound if you get out of range of your S Pen. The phone will make a sound. It would be cool if the pen had a speaker itself. So if you walked away or if you just lost it, you can just ping it from your phone. But I guess we'll just have to wait for the Note 10 to get that feature. So one last little S Pen tip is because it's now Bluetooth powered, you can reset it. So if you're clicking and nothing's happening, you can go to the S Pen remote setting screen, click on the little menu in the top right corner and click Reset S Pen. It'll ask you to insert your pen into the phone and it'll take a little bit of time, you know, like about 45 seconds, and it'll let you know when it's ready to be used again, and off you go. So there you have it. That's the Galaxy Note 9's new S Pen. It'll make your $1,000 note feel, well, like $1,000.